Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's look at basic layout using Pages. So I'm using Pages version 5 and we're going to look at doing some basic layout. Now in Pages you always start off with a word processing document. That means there's a large text area in the middle of the screen. We can see that by going to View Show Layout, which is something you're going to want to have turned on anyway if you're going to do layout. And you can see this large text box here. Now if you're doing page layout, like say you want to make a flyer or a newsletter or something, then you're not going to want this large box here meant for word processing. So the way to get to it is in your right sidebar here, you probably are looking at Format, or perhaps you even have it turned off. Either way, you want to go to Setup. And Setup, you want to go to Document. Then you want to turn off Document Body here. It's going to warn you. And then once you say, okay, I want to remove it, then that is gone. You still have the header and the footer, but you have this blank space that now you can add things to. So now you can begin adding elements. And probably one of the main things you want to add are text elements. These are just different styles of text boxes. Using the basic one is probably your best bet for most reasons. And you can just put it there. You can adjust it by dragging the dots on any side. If you go to the format here, then you can see you can switch to any of those different text styles and you can add your own. So as you make adjustments, you can hit this plus button here and add a new style there that you can then easily repeat. You can change the fill or the border. Let's add a border here. It's a simple line. And let's make it 1 point. And you can do other things like add a shadow and reflection and such. And then you could add any text that you want to it. So once you have some text, you probably want to add some other things. Like for instance, you could add photos. So I'm going to go to Media up here and I'm just going to grab a photo and then I can resize that as well. So now you can basically combine images and photos and build your own layout based on what you want. Let's add a headline here. I'm going to select multiple items by using Shift. And I can move this down. I'm going to add some new text here and move this up and make this a headline box. It's really no different than a regular text box. And then I can adjust things as I need. One useful thing if you're doing lots of this is you should learn how to group items. So for instance, let's say with this photo here that I want to put a caption right under it. And then I want to make sure if I'm going to move this photo around that the caption goes with it. I can use the Shift key to select both of these and I could group them together. So now they move as one unit. So that's something very important to do in layout. If you're doing layout, you may want to do a custom page size. You only have a limited number of choices for some standard page sizes here, but if you go to Page Setup, then you can look under Page Attributes, Format 4, and let's just do any printer here, and we can manage custom sizes. And I can create a new one and then set it to anything I want, so some sort of unusual size like 10 by 20. And I can hit OK, and you can see it's going to change to other here, and I've got 10 by 20. So you can do custom page sizes here. Let's zoom out and you can see this unusual page size. Also, as your document gets larger, you're going to want to make sure that you are looking at the thumbnails here on the left side so you could see the pages get built. So we can insert a new page here and continue to do that. Do three pages and jump easily between them. For more ideas, you may want to go and take a look at some of the templates here. Like for instance, let's take a look at some of these flyers and posters templates. And you could see how they are put together. You can see there's image there and boxes there. And you can kind of examine all of these and the different styles and formats and the setup for each one to get some ideas of what you can do.